I'm Ariel Gomez from the University of Virginia. I'm by chair of the Council on Hypertension. Together with Dr. Alexander Staruschensko, chair of the Council on Kidney and Cardiovascular Diseases, and on behalf of both councils, we wish to welcome you to our 2021 scientific sessions running from September 27 to September 29. Now, before we highlight some of the exciting components of the program, we would like to pause for a moment and remember those who are not with us, and also express our gratitude to those at all levels of our society that made enormous sacrifices to keep us healthy and ensure with their efforts that our society at large kept functioning. We also want to thank our trainees and lab personnel who kept our laboratories operating under the most difficult of circumstances. To all who contributed, we salute you. We also wish to extend our appreciation to members of the AHA staff and the council, like Susan Kunisch, Denise Levy, and Lily Noé, who devoted many hours to make this meeting possible. Last but not least, we want to thank our immediate past chair, Kurt Sigmund, Daichi Shimbo, Vivek Bala, and members of the Trainee Advisory Committee and all members of the programming committee for putting this meeting together. Now, this meeting, without doubt, is a testament to your resilience and your vocation to improve the health of patients who suffer from hypertension and kidney disease. As you know, our council meeting is considered one of the most important medical meetings on hypertension in the world. Throughout the meeting, you will have access to cutting-edge research on the causes of hypertension, its relationship to stroke, cardiac disease, and kidney diseases, and the most effective means for detecting, evaluating, and treating high blood pressure across diverse populations. In addition to basic sciences, this meeting also offers sessions designed for trainees and early career investigators, as well as clinical practice topics focus on applying clinical and basic science concepts to the providers treating patients with hypertension. So we have a fantastic, top quality program with a stimulating knowledge for everyone. And now I would like to invite Dr. Staruschensko to give us some highlights and details of the exciting days ahead.
I'm Alexander Staruschenko from the University of South Florida, and I'm the chair of the Council on Kidney and Cardiovascular Disease. I also would like to welcome you to the Hypertension Scientific Session meeting. This year, the Scientific Session program consists of 44 sessions, which include 8 clinical sessions, 12 moderated poster sessions, and 8 abstract sessions organized by the Training Advisory Committee. Over 180 posters will be presented in the virtual poster hall. We are excited to announce the conference will open with a keynote lecture given by the recipient of the 2019 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine, Dr. Greg Semenza from the Johns Hopkins University, who will talk about hypoxia-inducible factors in physiology and medicine. Importantly, trainers will have an opportunity to participate in the networking session and meet Dr. Semenza. There are also 2 networking sessions organized by the Hypertension Journal, specifically case study session and your career roundtable session. Furthermore, trainees will be able to participate in the funding and grant opportunity session, where they can meet the program officers from NHLBI, NIDDK, and the American Heart Association. We also have an exciting symposium on single-cell epigenomics and transcriptomics by leaders in the field, such as Kathleen Sustak and Benjamin Humphreys. They will also be available for a networking and Q&A session. As a chair of KCVD, I would also like to highlight the KCVD symposium focused on the role of uromodulin in hypertension, kidney disease, and inflammation, and the Donald Selden Award lecture given by Dr. David Madsen. Thus, we strongly encourage you to attend the meeting. We all hope that you will enjoy the meeting and have a good time. Please also continue discussions on social media using hashtag Hypertension2021. Please also remember that all registered attendees will be able to access all videos and e-posters on demand for 90 days after the conference. Finally, as the chairs of the next year programming committee, we would like to ask you to think about our next meeting. Please feel free to approach us with any comments and suggestions on how to improve the meeting. We hope we will be able to see each other in person in the fall of 2022. Thank you.